When we started working on this film, I sort of wished that I had done more of it, that I had made more video calls in life, because I'd be a little more comfortable. At least my body would know how to, you know, how to hold the phone and stuff. But here I had to start learning all of that.
Hey guys, I'm Shubhanka, and today I'm going to be talking to Roshan Mathew. Now we're going to talk to him about his film, See You Soon. It's something that, you know, we've never seen before as a full-fledged film. So, if I were, I don't think I should be asking you how your lockdown's been going, because I think you made a proper film during the lockdown. So, like, what was your reaction when you first heard about the story?
Yeah, I was definitely excited, and it wasn't even when I heard the story, I was excited even before that, just to get an opportunity to work with Fahad Fasil and Mahesh Narayanan. So I've been wanting to work with both of them. So I was already on board with this right from the first call that I got. And it was after that that I knew what the story was, that we had a proper script reading. And after that, I didn't know how we were going to shoot this during the lockdown. But later I was introduced to this format, and it was very difficult to understand, very honestly, especially the virtual cinematography part of it. So we just started shooting because it was very easy to trust the makers with this. It was very easy to trust the director to do what he wanted to do. So for us, our job was cut out, and then we started making it. And then I realized that this is not like anything I've done before. It's not like any of my previous acting experiences, and everything's so different. There are suddenly so many new problems, and then solving those problems became the exciting part of it.
Yeah, and it's and shooting from home is in itself quite a challenge. And in over here, it's like your only medium is a screen. So like, how much? And it's a thriller, so you know there are a lot of intricacies in it. So what was your most challenging part in the whole process?
So we weren't all in separate spaces. What we were lucky enough to do was also because of how the situation was in Kochi at that point in time. We were able to move into the same building, all of us in different apartments in the same building. And we're still doing it looking at the back of a phone, or you know, looking at an empty monitor. So the biggest challenge for me was not having a co-actor to play off of, and you know, in most scenes only having the sound of the lines and the way he or she would take those lines. That's all I had, so everything had to come from listening to them. So that for me was, I felt really blinded when that happened, because I also realized that I depend a lot on my co-actors. And that was, for me personally, that was the trickiest thing. I'm also generally very uncomfortable with you know, video calls, or you know, shooting self tapes, or making selfie videos of myself, selfie videos. But yeah, I've always been uncomfortable of that, and I've sort of given myself the luxury of not doing it as much as I could help. I've not done that stuff. So here, when we started working on this film, I sort of wished that I had done more of it, that I had made more video calls in life, because I'd be a little more comfortable. At least my body would know how to, you know, how to hold the phone and stuff. But here I had to start learning all of that from one. But the best part about it was that both of my co-actors, both Darshana and Fahad, were exactly like this. They're both people who are very uncomfortable with virtual mediums, didn't know anything. So all three of us had to start learning. So that way, I didn't feel like the only one with the disadvantage. Yeah. The disadvantage was everybody used to share.
So if I were to ask you, what was like your one takeaway from this film, like what would that be?
I think my biggest takeaway from this is the experience of, you know, the trial and error method that went into it. That the fact that because this format was new and unfamiliar to all of us, all of the problems were new, like I said earlier, and everyone's trying to solve everybody's problems, and that the certain sort of like team work, or just the good energy of a great team that comes with it, which I really enjoyed. I think that's my favorite memory, or my biggest takeaway from this.
And also talking about your film Capella, which released recently, so I couldn't help but notice how, you know, even that was a whole film based on a conversation on a telephone.
Yeah.
So
yeah.
Even I drew the parallel about how that is also something where, you know, two people don't meet each other. It's a yeah. conversation yeah. throughout, and even yeah. this is there. So is it like, you know, are you like unconsciously but gravitating towards the stories like that where you know
like virtual connection.
Virtual connection.
No, not at all. Actually, I was just telling someone else also that it wasn't until halfway through shoot for See You Soon that Mahesh Narayanan, the director, watched Kapela, and he came up to me and said, "Oh, so this is what happens in Kapela also, no?
Yeah.
Phone conversation," and that's when I realized that was the, because I hadn't thought about it at all, because the fact is that with See You Soon, that's a very small part of the story. It's actually a build up to the story that the film tells you. For one, hadn't thought about it at all. Here it's a completely different movie, and it's a thriller, and the story is something else altogether. And I'm definitely not the bad guy. So.
Yeah, from what you've said. Yeah, but how has the response been for Kapela?
It's been great. It's been great. I think the fact that, you know, everybody was sort of watching the movie at the same time almost, because it you know, it reached everyone at a point when everyone was probably looking for content, really helped generate a sort of buzz around the film.
Before I leave, you could tell us a little about what's coming up and what we can look forward to from you.
Oh, that really is the trickiest question in this context, because nobody knows what's coming up, right? I have a few exciting things lined up. There are a couple of films that we're already done shooting, movies which are ready in a way that will reach you in some point. One is a movie called Vartamanam with Parvati, directed by Siddharth Shiva. The other one is a movie that I've done again with Darshana, who's in See You Soon, directed by Ashik Abu, who did Virus, which is part of an anthology. So these are the two movies that are waiting to come out.